Hello and welcome again to Mixers Inside YouTube channel. This time we'll compare two mixers from the same brand that look almost identical if you look at their functions and layout. Let's take a closer look at Ecler Warm 2 and its ancestor Nuo 2.0. Nuo 2.0 on the left, Warm 2 on the right. It's very easy to see remarkable similarity between these two devices. The whole mechanic layout is based on the same core. Alp spots instead of channel volume faders, freeband master isolator and different power supply are the obvious differences. Will we be able to find more of them? This is how the mixers look after complete disassembly. Now we clearly observe the similarity in the mechanic layout. All common connectors, pots and switches share the same coordinates on the PCBs. The block diagram is very simple because most of the circuitry is placed on the mainboard. Let's take a closer look at it. Meters, isolator circuitry and channel equalizer. Those functional blocks cover the majority of space on the Warm 2 mainboard. Again, we clearly see layout similarity. Ecler Nuo 2.0 has almost identical mainboard. The thing that disappointed me a bit is that in Warm 2 they also used plastic shaft potentiometers. I prefer metal parts. The channel EQ pots are Alps RK14 model. So the first difference I want to point out is that Ecler Warm 2 has a 24 dB per octave master isolator. The circuitry is based on classic TL series op-amps, the standard way. It was possible to fit in the isolator on the front plate by removing crossfader section seen in Ecler 2.0. What was also removed in Warm 2 is VCA channel volume control. I briefly described this concept in the Xone 92 video. Channel volume in Nuo 2.0 is controlled by analog device's VCA chip, while volume control in Warm 2 is simply using a stereo potentiometer and it can be classified as passive. Channel EQs in both Warm 2 and Nuo 2.0 are freeband full-kill equalizers. In other words, channel EQs are 12 dB per octave isolators. The difference lies in capacitor types used. Warm 2 uses ceramic capacitors for filtering, while Nuo 2.0 uses film caps. It's hard to say which solution is better here because it's impossible to determine the capacitor type based on visual inspection. We know that in Warm 2 they used MLCC ceramic type, but there are several types of MLCC capacitors. Some of them shouldn't be used for filtering circuits. There is the same case with film capacitors. We know that they used film caps, but we don't know the material of the film. It's also a very important parameter in terms of audio reproduction quality. Another difference I've spotted on the mainboard is different approach of controlling the LED meters. Warm 2 uses digital circuitry and do it with microcontroller, while Nuo 2.0 uses analog meter driver. It's worth to mention that the meter circuitry type shouldn't affect the sound quality at all. Now let's see what input PCBs of Warm and Nuo have in common. For sure, different connector colors. Unfortunately, red connectors don't make the sound faster. Line inputs are TL072 based and are equipped with overvoltage protection diodes. Phono input is single-stage active solution based on 4580 op-amp, also seen in Omnitronic Mixer Phono preamp. We can see two film and two MLCC capacitors in Phono preamp filter in Warm 2 and four film caps in Nuo 2.0 Phono stage. And this is the only difference between Warm 2 and Nuo 2.0 input boards that I spotted. Op-amp models are the same. Even the tracks on the PCB bottom layer have identical layout. Time to take a look at output boards. Output boards are responsible for buffering and balancing the output signals and partly handling send and return signals. Signal balancing is done by two halves of 5532 op-amp per channel. In Nuo 2.0 they used op-amp in large package, probably for better heat dissipation. Warm 2 output board is just identical. The only difference is that the output balancing op-amp is in a different package and from a different manufacturer. They even kept old footprint in the new PCB. Let's get back to more serious differences and examine the headphone output board that is expanded with fader curve control circuitry in Nuo 2.0. Warm 2 headphone amp is a low-cost solution seen also in Omnitronic TRM202. It's based only on 4556 high output current op-amp. Nuo 2.0 is expanded with fader curve control circuitry thanks to usage of VCA volume control. It's very easy to electronically control the curve in such circuits. Nuo 2.0 and Warm 2 share the same concept of headphone amplification. Now it's time to look at last very important boards. Power supply boards have physically the same dimensions and are separated from other circuits by thick metal sheet. It helps to reduce electromagnetic interference. Rectifier, big capacitor, switching transistor, PWM controller, transformer, filtering caps. Power supplies in both Nuo 2.0 and Warm 2 are switch mode isolated ones. The power supply design in Warm 2 share the same philosophy but use different elements. I've noticed one difference in output filtering section. Warm 2 uses pretty big coils to filter out the DC voltage while Nuo 2.0 doesn't. We've seen all the boards and spotted some differences. Now let's start my favorite part and see if those differences affect the distortion performance of the mixers. But first I want to tell you something about my measurement setup.
Alright, so here's my very simple measurement setup. Let's start with the source. I feed the mixer with the very low distortion sine wave. This is the generator. And I feed the mixer with 2V RMS input. 2V RMS because the most popular CD players on the market, Pioneer CDJs, have this output level, 2V RMS. So I feed the mixer with 2V RMS, line input, channel 2, right channel, and then the signal goes through the mixer, and then I want to observe the output. So with the output cable, I go to the very high quality ADC. It's analog to digital converter. It converts the analog signal to digital domain. And then when we have the signal in digital domain, we can make several operations on it. For example, make FFT, fast Fourier transform, which allows us to observe the output signal in the frequency domain, analyze the frequency components of the signal, and analyze parameters like, for example, total harmonic distortion.
As I mentioned before, I use high-performance, low-distortion gear. When measuring the signal straight from the generator with my ADC, I get about minus 126 dB of THD. In our case, we can consider the measurement setup highly transparent. Let's start with Nuo 2.0. With 0 dB on the meters, we get around minus 69 dB of THD. The second harmonic is dominant here. Let's raise the signal a bit, till plus 4 on the meters. The distortion figure worsened about 5 dB. Now let's overload the mixer and glow all the LEDs. The distortion figure worsened another 5 dB. We get minus 59 dB of THD in the overload condition. With 0 dB on the meters, signal in Warm 2 is much cleaner. The distortion figure is 20 dB better than in Nuo 2.0, that's a lot. Also again, the second harmonic is dominant. It goes along with the definition of warm sound, but not very saturated. Raising the signal till plus 4 dB on the meters worsens the THD about 5 dB. Now let's try to overload the mixer and see what happens. We see tons of distortion, we are heavily distorting the signal. When using Warm 2 with such sources as CDJs, try to not exceed plus 4 on the meters, otherwise the signal will start to clip. For sure you're wondering now why almost the same mixers have completely different distortion figures. I blame this guy. VCA chips have strong sound signature, especially analog devices SSM2164, also used in Fersk Zone 92 mixers. Passive implementation of volume control in Warm 2 is not more expensive than VCA approach, but helps to get rid of high distortion levels introduced by VCA chip. I personally like the sound of SSM2164 VCAs, but if you're looking for something transparent, stay away from them. So to quickly sum up the video, the major difference between Warm 2 and Nuo 2.0 is channel volume control circuit. Neither of these circuits is better, each has its own strengths and weaknesses. If you want to keep the sound more transparent, you want to choose passive volume control offered by Warm 2. Other than that, the signal path is nearly the same apart from isolator circuitry versus crossfader circuitry. If you are looking for fat saturated sound, you should paradoxically choose Nuo 2.0 despite the name of Warm 2. In terms of pricing, I just want to put it this way. For sure, Warm 2 looks more shiny, fresh and expensive, from the outside. Thanks for watching this video and all the comments and support I received from you so far. It really means a lot for me and I'm looking forward for creating some kind of community. And speaking of community, I want to answer frequently asked question by you. You ask all the time to do some mixers like Duke Sound 96, do master sounds, blah blah. And I fully respect that you want some quality content from me, and it's really, I'm happy to read those comments, but I simply can't afford all those mixers. And what I want to say is that I'm not able to film all the mixers without your help. This channel is not supported by any company, and this allows to keep the content unbiased and marketing free.